The most important person in my life is my husband.
In an emergency, the first people that would come to my mind would be my children and my wife.
If something were to happen, my son would be the first person that would come to mind.
The most important person to me would be my son, Jack.
Probably my brother, my mother, my father immediately, you know, comes to mind.
My daughter, Allison.
Our kids are a little bit older, they're 19 and 15, but yes, they do still rely on us if anything happens.
Definitely, I'd be concerned about my brother in an emergency.
My son, Samuel, and he definitely is the most important thing in my life.
Who is nearest and dearest to your heart? If an emergency happens in your community, who or what comes to mind first? Who would need you most? Let's face it, if disaster strikes, emergency drills and strategies aren't going to be the first things to enter your mind. Your loved ones will. They are the reason for emergency preparedness. But what if you're at work when something happens? How will you get in touch with the people who mean the most to you, and how will you get to them? There's no way of knowing what type of crisis might happen or when it will strike, but there are three easy steps that will help you take control of any tragic situation, from a terrorist attack to a tornado. First, create a plan for you and your family. Second, prepare an emergency kit. And third, listen for information about what to do and where to go during an actual emergency. The program is called Ready in 3, and it will help get you and your family ready for anything. Many workplaces across the state of Missouri, and each one has its own specific needs when it comes to emergency preparedness. Still, there are some basic steps every employee can take to plan for an emergency. And believe me, it's a lot easier than our friend Bunker Bob makes it. The first step is to create an emergency plan. Chances are your employer already has a policy in place. Make sure you know what that plan is, whether you need to evacuate the building or stay put. If you are asked to stay in the building, there are a few things to keep in mind. If there are clients, customers, or visitors in the building, ask them to stay and let them know where to go. Hopefully, your employer has already determined a safe room or rooms for everyone to gather. It should be an interior room with the fewest windows or vents and large enough for the designated group. It should also have a landline telephone and emergency supplies. If you can, close and lock all windows and doors in your office on your way out and grab your personal emergency kit and take it with you. Also, if you have time, forward your calls to your cell phone or a phone in the safe room in case family members are trying to reach you. If you are able to call out and reach your loved ones, remember to keep your calls to a minimum and keep conversations short so others can get through. Of course, some emergencies will call for an evacuation of the premises, forcing you and your coworkers to a meeting place outside your building where everyone can gather. Find out your company's building evacuation plan and pay attention during drills. Part of the plan also lies in your hands. Have an alternate means of transportation and plan alternate routes for getting to and from work in case your normal mode of transportation is interrupted. It's also a good idea to talk to coworkers with special needs and ask if they need any help. People with disabilities typically know what assistance they will need in an emergency. Whether you stay or go, your loved ones are going to be at the top of your mind. Let's hear the stories from some other Missourians to see if we can learn from their experiences.
My brother and I bought walkie-talkies for my parents because they're always out on the land by themselves. Actually, one time they were injured on the land. Both of them were in the same accident. And my brother and I didn't even know about it for weeks until we saw my mom with stitches in her face, you know.
It was like a rainstorm. It was lightning, thundering. It was like the worst kind of weather. And we were driving, and my sister just up and said out loud, she's like, isn't there a dip here? We hit this thing, went down, water started coming in the car. I tried to open the door, that sunk us even further, so we all ended up having to basically swim out of the biggest puddle in the world.
Our oldest boy got home from school first and called me on his cell phone and said, I think we've been broken into, there's something wrong with the house, there's stuff all over the house. Well, luckily he wasn't in the house, he was outside, he had gone back outside. I said, stay outside, call the police on your cell phone, I'm on my way home.
The entire neighborhood lost power, and we had a full restaurant and we had, you know, full staff here, so we had to basically take care of getting the kitchen shut down, talking with the customers, getting them out safe.
I have family in Columbine, and at the time they had students in high school. Now it happened to be another high school, but that was a situation where the family communication network went into place and we had to make sure everyone was okay, and luckily everyone in both those situations were.
About a month ago there was an incident that happened at the Praxair plant down about four blocks away. It was in the middle of the afternoon one day. There's fireball shooting from this plant and cars on fire and the whole street shut off, and just kind of this painted this chaotic picture for us. And you know, here we are three blocks away with clients during our work day wondering what in the world is going on.
Our cell phones were, the service wasn't working, and probably because of the explosion, everyone in my family was trying to get a hold of me but couldn't because they couldn't get through on my cell phone because we have no service at all.
There are so many things we cannot control, but there are some we can. Sit down with your family and try to think of as many emergency scenarios as possible. Who can pick up your kids if you can't get there? Who should your family members call if you are all separated when disaster strikes? The Missouri Department of Health and Senior Services has a family safety guide and family plan that can walk you through the simple process. But here are some of the basics. Your family plan should include contact information for family members, a meeting place where you can reunite if something happens while you're not together, and an out-of-town friend or family member for everyone to call in case your family is separated and local phone lines are down. You'll also want to decide on a safe room in your home and an evacuation location where your family can stay if you can't stay at home. It's a good idea to make copies of your family plan for each family member to keep with them. That way, everyone has it when they need it, and you won't have to rely on your memory in a tense situation. To request a copy of the Family Safety Guide and Family Plan, you can call 573-526-4768. At the very least, having a family plan in place helps calm anxieties before and during an emergency. At the most, it can reunite a family or even save lives.
Hey!